We went into the schools with sex education programs that we knew would increase the sexual activity and therefore the pregnancy rate.
And I turned to look at the screen and thought, that looks like a baby. Well, she got very upset and yelled at me and said, turn around, don't you dare look at that.
She told me that it wasn't even a baby yet, that it was just a clump of cells.
This is the pregnancy expert saying, there it is, you're pregnant. And then grab her by the bony part of the elbow and squeeze. Do you have your money? Can you do it today?
The lie. I now know she didn't show me my baby. She just showed me a dot on the screen so that I would go through with the abortion.
I really felt like my soul was being sucked out that day.
It was excruciatingly painful, and I almost passed out.
They sucked the life out of my body that I knew I'd never be able to get back.
And I heard one nurse say to the other nurse, it's twins. And then she took the trash bag and she tied it in a knot and she walked out with the twins in that trash bag.
I wanted to meet them. I wanted to see what they would have looked like, their voices.
They said my life would get back to normal again. It's never been back to normal again.
The grief and trauma and shame that we as women deal with this choice, I wouldn't wish on my worst enemy.
I began to have suicidal thoughts, and I made a suicide attempt.
I lay on the table and started thinking, how am I going to tell my husband that I'm not going to be able to have children with him? It was the reality of knowing that the only three children I would ever bear, I killed.
I would just encourage any woman that found themselves in the same situation that they would really think twice about it, and that they wouldn't let fear lead them to make a decision that they would regret the rest of their life.
I was in my 20s, married. My child was a little over a year old. When I learned I was pregnant again, I was almost 3 months pregnant when I found out. And we traveled to visit my granny, who had been in the hospital with cancer for quite a long time. This day, I kissed her goodbye and told her I loved her. And then we headed home, many miles away. And we drove every month to see her. Because I never knew when would be the last time I'd kiss her goodbye. On the way home, we stopped at an ice cream store, Brahms, my favorite, to get some ice cream. And when we left there, and I stepped up to get in the car, the only thing I can describe this would be I felt a rip in the bottom of my stomach and I began to spot. And I fell white-faced in the middle of nowhere. What do you do in the middle of the night? And I cried, oh God, help me. And I lay in the back of the car as I was driven home, and I was immediately rushed to the hospital and given bed fast for a week. And then at the end of that week, one morning, I was awakened by the voice of my husband talking in the middle of the hallway to a nurse. I overheard them, and he said, I need to talk to her alone. Please, please don't interrupt us. And he came in that morning. He was very kind and gentle, and he took my hand and he said, I've taken the week off so I can be with you. So don't worry anymore. Everything has been taken care of. And then he paused and he stumbled for words. And he said, I need to tell you something. I don't really know how, but your granny passed away this morning. And so has our baby. They'll be coming soon to take you to surgery. And I can't tell you the overwhelming emptiness that came over me at that very moment when he told me those words, that your granny has passed away and so has our baby. The rush of emotions that went through me, and I'm still feeling as I'm telling you this on this video. It was so overwhelming. But at the same time, I knew they both were in heaven. And I knew that my granny was holding my baby with great love. The tears flooded me. I can't tell you. I just can't tell you. And I'm telling you at this very moment, the reason I'm telling you this is that every small baby that has been aborted around the world up to this very second is in heaven, being loved on and cared by someone's loving granny, just like mine was that morning. They're not alone. Even though it broke my heart, I can't tell you how much. And I grieved for a very, very long time because I'd loved my granny and I lost my child. That was 30 years ago. But I'm here to tell you that in Psalms 147:3, it says that Yesu was sent to mend your broken heart and all your wounds. You know, they say that time heals all wounds, but no, Yesu does. Because he's the healer and our master. And if you have never allowed him to touch you in that broken place in your heart, today's your day. We're told not to murder. That's one of the Ten Commandments. It's in Exodus 20 and 13. But you know, that's not an unforgivable sin. He said, come unto me as a little child. And if you can remember when you were a little child and you did something wrong and you would go to your mom, remember what it felt like and how you acted? That's how we're supposed to come to the Father. That's how easy it is. Yeah, it is. It really is. You just say, Father, look at me. I'm a sinner. I've done so many sins all my life, Father, and I know that you know them. But Father, forgive me. It's this easy. Just repeat after me. Father, I'm a sinner. I've done all these sins. You see them. And you know them. Please forgive me in Jesus' name. And yes, that is his name. He loves you so much. Believe me, he does. Because Jesus died on the cross. And he rose again. And I know, Father, that he's sitting at your right hand. Holy Spirit, come into me. And help me to live right. And to walk in God's ways. Help me to shun all the ways of the world. Father, in Jesus' name, heal me. Help me to lose all this shame. Thank you, Father, for forgiving me. And if you didn't pray right now, you can go back over this video and pray it later. Why go on with all the pain and all the hurt and the shame of what you've done yesterday and live with all this sin? No, I have never had an abortion. But the pain of losing a child, no matter how you lost it, doesn't matter. You don't have to live with it anymore when you can be forgiven by the Father in Jesus' name. That's what he's for. Don't listen to what the world says. The world lies. Be forgiven today. That's what this video was for. So you can be forgiven. This is Ruby. Be blessed.